We take you to breaking news. Oof. We are on the streets of East L.A. We are looking at a pursuit. This started, we believe, in Orange County, in Anaheim, Marla. And now we're looking at a white Fusion through the streets of East L.A.
Yeah, so this has been picked up by CHP, maybe LAPD at this point, now that we're on the streets of Los Angeles. Alex said that this started in Orange County. Anaheim police originally picked this up some time ago. We understand that this vehicle reached speeds beyond 90 miles per hour on the 710 freeway at one point near Long Beach. And now here we are. We want to bring in, of course, Rick Dickard into our coverage. Rick, it's late. Not a lot of traffic, which is always a good thing. Nonetheless, still dangerous.
Just made a right turn on McBride Avenue coming off of Olympic, that major surface street that runs east-west across the basin. You could see that Ford Fusion there being pursued, hitting the brakes. Unclear if he knows really where he's going. We do mention there's a LAPD airship or law enforcement airship just busted through that stop sign there, barely even slowed down. We do see suspects at times go into neighborhoods that they are familiar with. There's another officer there on both sides of the street, so they are in the area already. This driver has slowed down quite a bit compared to what we just saw a few moments ago. Now it looks like he's turning into an alley there and being trailed by the lead agency of the California Highway Patrol, Marla and Alex.
So as far as we know, we believe this started with a failure to yield, which oftentimes is what it started with, but there's more to the story than that, which means they tried to pull this person over and they kept going.
Headlights off.
Oftentimes, Rick, when that is the start of a pursuit, it really means that they may be wanted for something, or they have warrants out for their arrest, or there's more of a backstory other than just this guy didn't pull over.
Exactly. They ran the plates. They waited for additional units to arrive on scene very close right there.
Oh, my goodness.
And that looks to be an L.A. County Sheriff's helicopter that is circling above this pursuit. Back onto Olympic Boulevard. That's where we just saw him turn off of, or her. Unclear if there's anybody else inside the vehicle there. That would likely be the 710 freeway that he just went under there in the Southgate, East Los Angeles area. Olympic Boulevard here again. Olympic makes its way from the east side of downtown LA all the way across through downtown Los Angeles towards the west side here off of Bundy Drive where we're located.
So we're now being told that this was a felony failure to yield, and there's some concern that this driver may be armed, Marla, which is part of the reason that maybe law enforcement has taken the approach of being on top of him or her and then backing off. And we have seen several times, Marla, this driver turning off their headlight.
Yeah, that's a good point. I was just going to make the same observation. We've seen the headlights on,
red light,
then off again, passing through red lights. And Rick, when we have just that little bit of new information about felony, about possibly armed, we talk about strategies, a pit maneuver. Obviously, this is just he's going or she's going way too fast for that. There are spike strips that could be used to perhaps. And then the idea of circling a particular neighborhood.
Yeah, that's right. And you can see that night sun, the law enforcement helicopter, which I saw across the screen there, is an L.A. County Sheriff's helicopter there, circling overhead just by a few hundred feet, tracking it from the air and on the ground. Lights off again. We saw this driver run through a handful of red lights already. Now on 8th Street in Lorena. This is the Boyle Heights, East Los Angeles area. This is where the 60 and the 5 freeway meet. And there's that illumination again, the night sun tracking this white Ford Fusion here through the surface streets of Boyle Heights. A dangerous situation. And yes, you mentioned, Marla, the tactics that these officers can use, the PIT maneuver, the pursuit intervention technique. That is what the PIT acronym stands for there. But we do like to see speeds below 35 miles an hour, mostly to conduct one. But again, they have to look at other automobiles in the area, make sure there's no pedestrians or bicyclists. They have to do it in a safe fashion so they do not injure anybody else. But lights off again, being pursued again, a felony want. So they ran the plates, and the individual connected to this vehicle is wanted for some sort of felony. They lit him or her up, didn't pull over, and the pursuit was on.
And when we say pit maneuver, that would essentially be law enforcement driving alongside, tapping the vehicle, trying to get it to spin out, lose control, so that way they could arrest that driver. So, you know, Marla, as we look at this, you know, there are a lot of people that clearly like to watch pursuits for entertainment purposes and view it sort of as a video game and enjoying to see how this whole thing is going to end. Clearly, there's a massive fascination with that. But in recent days, we've been reminded, including a couple of the stories we already did in this newscast a bit earlier, how deadly pursuits can be, how this is not a game, and sometimes the crashes that result from pursuits or from this reckless driving that we see on the streets, it can just be awful for innocent bystanders.
Yeah, we've seen innocent bystanders.
Is this a 6th Street Bridge?
It is a 6th Street Bridge.
Yeah, crossing over the L.A. River there, heading into downtown Los Angeles now. Yeah, and really picking up speeds again. Look at that. With our Extreme Nav system, we can track the speeds of these pursuits. Still blacked out. There are no headlights on that vehicle at this time. Whoa. You could see the speed of the normal traffic that is on the bridge here. 6th Street Bridge crossing over the Los Angeles River and really ripping now. 80 plus miles an hour, close to 90 miles an hour, heading into downtown Los Angeles.
Yes, and Alex, as you were saying, that these pursuits often turn deadly for innocent bystanders. That's what we've seen recently. In recent days. And that happens even when law enforcement decides to back off and go into what they consider tracking mode. That's when they decide to do that, when it's just too much of a danger to public safety. That's what this initial pursuit began as. It was in tracking mode. Then they decided to go full pursuit mode. So here we are. But at some point, it could get into, despite it not being heavily trafficked, it could be a really, they could decide to pull off out of concern for innocent bystanders.
And they may have already done that, because we don't see any law enforcement vehicles that close to this
red light
vehicle. He's clearly, or she, driving knowing that the helicopters are above, but we don't see a bunch
any
of patrol
units.
Cars mm-hmm. right behind. And now we're going into downtown Los Angeles.
3rd Street.
This is areas, obviously, with pretty large buildings, which might make it a little more challenging for Skyfox. In terms of following this vehicle.
And law enforcement helicopters as well, because we always say they're down in the dirt, meaning they're just a few hundred feet AGL tracking these pursuits, while we are up at least 1,000, maybe 1,500 feet. But you could see.
But y'all pretty face and we still gone. And I'm making them we hold on. And I'm making them we hold on. We hold on. We hold on. Like damn, she and her move. 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 She lit. Get money too. Like damn, she and her move. Keep it a bug.